what about the Democrats are offering? I mean, I hear you, the two of you, saying different things about whether Americans want what the Democrats are debating and still haven't been able to pass yet. John.
Well, I think that's the problem. They still haven't been able to pass it. If you tease out every little thing out of both the infrastructure bill, which we all know has bipartisan support, but even what's in the Build Back Better Act, last I checked, there's so many things in it. But if you tease out the individual pieces, they have popular support. It's just that if you're going to go for it and you've got the House and you've got the Senate and you have the White House, to the larger American public who doesn't follow all of this stuff the way we do, they sit back and think, why can't you get anything done if you have all three of these branches? And that's why this is such a problem for Democrats and the president.
What I hear you saying, Gary, is even if they pass this other mm-hmm. piece of legislation, that mm-hmm. may not help the Democrats.
I think it hurts them. I think that that's again, I'm going to say, and Jonathan and I are disagreeing on this, but the message Tuesday was, we don't like the direction you're going. Yeah. You know, the Democrats really, if they stopped to evaluate what happened Tuesday, they would be better off sitting and letting Joe Manchin lead the discussion while Bernie Sanders and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez kind of sit to the side a little bit and listen. Because I think Manchin, to his credit, kind of has the pulse on where America is at right now. And no, the Democrat Party doesn't have to become the Republican Party. But Joe Manchin's, you know, a pretty centrist Democrat who's trying to wave the red flag and ring the warning bells, and no one's listening to him yet.
Okay. The Democratic Party in the Build Back Better plan, for instance, would love for there to be paid family leave. And I guess conservatives look at paid family leave as paying people to stay home instead of looking at the domino effect of what it means in order for a family to not risk their job in order to stay home for whatever reason, grieving the loss of a parent, a new child coming into the
right.
family. There are economic benefits that the American people want, the earned income tax credit for children, any number of things. I don't think it's that the American people don't want these things and that these aren't, you know, a grab bag of things to just give away. They have a benefit for the long-term health and security, economic and well-being of this country.
I think Americans do want a lot of those things, and they do poll as popular item by item. But Americans love ice cream. If you did a poll, you'd find out that almost 100% of Americans love ice cream. It doesn't mean they approve of spending trillions of dollars to give everyone free ice cream. Not everybody can have things that we all agree, gee, that would be nice. But at some point in time, there comes a point where we have to say, we don't have any money. You know, I mean, I don't care if we're talking 6 trillion, 3 trillion, 1 trillion. It doesn't exist. So I think the American people know that too. Yeah, we'd like to have all these things, but do our great-grandchildren pay for it?
One of